BNP Paribas, one of Europe's largest banks, reports results for the full year 2012. Jean-Laurent Bonnafé, welcome.
Thank you.
You are the CEO of BNP Paribas. What are your comments on the group's performance for the full year and in the fourth quarter?
In 2012, BNP Paribas delivered solid results in a challenging environment, successfully completing the adaptation plan announced in September 2011. Net income for the group reached 6.6 billion euros, marking an 8.3% improvement on the previous year and confirming a competitive profit generation capacity. Revenues of the operating divisions showed good resilience, benefiting from the diversification of our business model, while good cost control was conferred across the board. Over the full year, cost of risk showed a moderate increase in a difficult economic environment, reaching a level of 58 basis points as a percentage of customer loans. During the year, BNP Paribas continued to increase its deposit base, as confirmed by retail banking deposits, which were up 7% compared to the previous year. Domestic markets contributed with a 5% increase, and similarly, corporate banking deposits in CIB reached 55 billion euros, 18% higher than a year ago. In the fourth quarter, the operating division showed a good operating performance as compared with the fourth quarter of 2011, which was impacted by the sovereign crisis. Cost of risk increased in specific areas, notably at BNL in Italy and in CIB, where one large ticket explained most of the increase. Excluding one-offs, the net result for the quarter amounted to almost 1.1 billion euros. In 2012, BNP Paribas completed its adaptation to the changing environment, both in terms of solvency and liquidity. On the solvency front, our Common Equity Tier 1 ratio under fully loaded Basel III reached 9.9% at year-end, exceeding our original target of 9%. In terms of liquidity, we more than doubled our surplus of stable funding to 69 billion euros at the end of this year. All this translates into continuing value creation for our shareholders, as our book value per share increased to about 61 euros, while the tangible book value per share exceeded 50 euros.